Do subscribe to Ekeeda channel and press bell icon to get updates about latest engineering, HSE and IIT JEE main and advanced videos.
Hello friends, now we are going to talk about the numerical which is based on standard Gibbs free energy change at equilibrium. So let us do that. So this is a numerical which is based on standard Gibbs free energy change at equilibrium. So let us talk about this thing. So we have to calculate the Kp, that is the equilibrium constant, if the pressure when in terms of pressure that we have to calculate for the reaction that we have for C2H4 plus H2, that should give us C2H6. Basically the ethene when it's reacted or when it is under reduction process so as to form, that is C2H6, that is nothing known as ethene. And the delta G naught or the standard Gibbs free energy change, it has been found to be minus 100 kilojoule per mole and at 25 degrees Celsius. So this is are the data that are been given in this thing. So let us extract the data and let us see that what would be the answer for Kp that we will get. So the first thing that we are going to do is we'll write the data for this thing. So therefore the given data is, that is the delta G naught, that is nothing known as the standard Gibbs free energy change. It is given as minus 100 kilojoule per mole. So it's better that we should convert into joules. So therefore it would be basically minus 100 into 10 raised to 3 joules per mole. So this is the value of Gibbs free energy change, standard Gibbs free energy change. And in this case, the temperature is also been provided to us. The temperature has been provided as 25 degrees Celsius, or basically it is known as 298 Kelvin. It has been provided, and from that we have to calculate the Kp or the equilibrium constant in terms of pressure. But we know the formula that delta G has a relationship between with the Gibbs standard Gibbs energy change, that is delta G equals to delta G naught plus RT log of quotient, that is a reaction quotient. But when I have when we have did a derivation based on that, or when we have did a standard Gibbs free energy change, and on that what we have did, what we have got to know that at equilibrium the quotient, that is Q, it becomes K. K is nothing known as equilibrium constant, and at equilibrium constant the delta G will be zero. So that's the reason here the delta G is not been mentioned, and for that we could say that since in this case it is been present in equilibrium, so therefore the delta G will be zero. So only one thing is been left with us is the formula that we have. So we have a formula, that is for standard Gibbs free energy change, that is delta G naught is equals to minus 2.303 RT log to the base 10 of Kp, or we could say it as the constant that we have. But in this case, the delta G naught is been given to us, and from that we have to calculate the value of Kp. So the delta G naught is been found to be basically minus 100 into 10 raised to 3 joules. This is what we have, into minus of, that is 2.303 into R. R is nothing known as the gas constant, and it has a value of 8.314 into the temperature, and the temperature is been found to be that is 298 Kelvin, so I will write it here, into log of Kp. So now what I am going to do, I will find out first that what will be the log of Kp, because I will substitute these values over here and let us see that what is the answer we could get. But before that, let me give you a short precaution in this thing, that whenever we have taken here minus, so it should not be get confused. So therefore what I am going to do is I am going to eliminate these values. So now it will be very much easy, because sometimes this science will be playing a very vital role in solving the numerical in a right direction or in a wrong direction. So that is the reason what I am going to do. I'll divide this 100 into 10 raised to 3 with this numbers that we have. So therefore I could write it as 100 into 10 raised to minus 100 into 10 raised to 3, the whole divided by, that is 2.303 into 8.314 into 298, and that will be equal to nothing but log of Kp that I have to calculate. So let us see what is the value of this thing that I will get. So we have got a value of, that is log of Kp is nothing but 17.5258. So this is the value that we have got, but we have to calculate the value of Kp. So how can we calculate that? It is very much easy. So therefore the log of Kp that we have got here is basically log of Kp is nothing but 17.5258. So to calculate Kp, what I'm going to do, because if the log will shift over here, then this would be nothing but the anti-log. So anti-log of 17.5258 can be calculated. So let us see what is the answer of that. So we have got a value of 3.355 into 10 raised to 17. So this is the value of Kp, or we could say it as the equilibrium constant in terms of pressure we have calculated, and in this case it was found to be, that is 3.355 into 10 raised to 17. So this is how we can calculate the value of Kp with the help of the standard Gibbs free energy change that has been provided to us at equilibrium and at a given temperature. So thank you friends for watching this video. I hope you have liked this video and you will solve this kind of numerical more and more. So share this video with your friends, and yes, don't forget to subscribe to Ekeeda channel. Thank you so much.